Howdy folks, and welcome back to this Let's Play of Stellaris, which we're currently playing, of course, as the human species focusing purely on psionics. Alright, so the game is loaded. Let's have a look at where we are. We have just entered a system here with our fleet. By the way, my name is Nidus, if you haven't guessed that yet. And we're going to give this fleet orders to actually engage a pirate fleet here. So I thought that'd be a nice beginning for today's episode. Engaged.
Research just complete.
Basically put a new weapon outfit on, of course, all of my ships here. Look at that. What's that happened to do? We're actually able to engage them. Versus 1.1, drop to 3.8, versus 1.0, 3.6, 900, look at the intensity of that, isn't that stunning, isn't that gorgeous? We've dropped significantly in strength here. Still up to two crews, but our number of corvettes has dropped significantly. It's really the destroyers that are basically keeping us alive at the moment. We recovered its strong room module, which gives me minerals as well as energy credits.
Situation log updated.
Okay, hold on. Pausing that for just a second. So our society research had finished, it looks like. So what's our next target? Now, can we choose for growth speed, or we can choose for atmospheric manipulation? Unlock feature, atmospheric manipulation. What does that do? Humidity regulators, chemical dispersion is a first step towards a fundamental altered atmosphere. Resettlement cost, biolab. Gonna go for this one. Hopefully we can do some terraforming with that one. That's what it sounds like, at least. Need a science vessel for this purpose. Where is this one here? Let's have a look at first off, where is our fleet? It's over there. And this here is one of my science ships, which is currently on the way here. Now why is it on the way here? Sorry, is that a science ship? It is. Preparing to upgrade, okay. Okay, so let's take this ship here. And we gained some extra ships, of course, because of us taking on that other civilization. Okay, good. Do I need to upgrade this ship here? No? Research project there, followed by a survey. And of course, in the meantime, I can actually go back to my fleet here and look at how that final bit of the engagement actually unfolds here. Now, in the meantime, I want to basically go back to Earth and basically issue orders for the construction of more destroyers, making up for some of the losses I've suffered here. 3.2.
Situation log updated. Construction complete.
Cool. Our admiral has gained a level. Alright, let's have a look at this engagement here. So as you can see, we lost 8 corvettes out of the 16 we had. We killed 32 raiders and we killed 1 outpost. Now there is a second outpost here, so we are slowly going to make our way towards that. We did suffer some damage. It's not massive, but yeah, it is still some damage that we suffered.
Construction complete.
On the surface, we finished some construction items. to the spaceport here. We are currently, of course, got in the queue a couple of items here. Observatory is one of the key ones there. Scientists have leveled up. Governor has leveled up. Perfect. Does this world already have a governor? Nope, we don't have a governor for this world here yet. So we can actually recruit a new governor here. They're all pretty much similar, except for this
hostile station engaged.
Okay. So again, we are engaging them, it looks like. Missiles are being fired at us. We will hopefully be able to, of course, destroy those. As you can see, we are indeed destroying them. Let's have a brief look at actually what is this. Spiritual militaristic. Okay. I could get the Murmark, so I think we wanted to. I'm not going to transfer anything. Do I want to basically give them research? I can give more access, that's fine. Hopefully that makes them a bit more pliable. Look at all those beams. They're of course hopefully they'll actually re-engage for the feature first. From 3.1, we're still at the same strength. But we will be losing one or two ships in suspense.
Transmission.
Okay, that is the Oscott West Mandate. Quite happy with that offer. Let's go back to where we were. 2.9 we've dropped down to. 8. We're still fighting 2.7. We've lost all of our corvettes now. We've destroyed the pirate station.
Situation log updated.
2.6. Can we keep it up? We just jumped up by a little bit because I guess one of the extra ships has joined us now. Alright, let's see where that fleet is now heading. Slowly heading back, which is fine.
Construction complete.
And our admiral has again leveled up, which actually reduces his maintenance costs, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, 8 corvettes were lost. None of my destroyers were lost, so that's good. Raiders were lost on their side, and of course that outpost. Anything else on the surface I need to basically work on? Yeah, of course these here can be upgraded, these power plants. I haven't got anything here yet. What shall I build here, is then the question. I can actually go for the Pleasure Dome. Paradise Dome, I should call it. Happiness is increased. Let's go for that one then. I can actually put a research facility on here. Basic research. Another research facility here. What I will be building here will be a temple later on. Let's first kick up the game speed here first.
Incoming transmission.
Ah, they will be giving us energy credits and minerals in exchange for one of my resources, the Yukuntra crystals. And I've got one in excess, so I could indeed go for a deal. no species, non-species-wide slavery. hold on, Alien 8 Alliance. The wholesale enslavement of an entire species will greatly displease the Alien 8 Alliance. Now, have we enslaved them? I don't think we have. I'm doing a purge, multicultural society, hosting at least 4 unique species within our empire will please the Alien 8 Alliance. Okay, how many people have we got in there? Ah, we finished a bit of research. It didn't actually give me a timer, I thought. Let's track these on the map just to keep them all safe there. And let's choose our next item of research. Planetary fortification toughness can be increased. Advanced combat rolls. Or, of course, the AI-controlled colony ships. Colony development speed is increased. Let's go for that one. 12 months. Should be a relatively quick one as such.
System survey complete.
Let's have a look at all the key ships that we have. Let's upgrade this one here. Sending that one back towards there. Now that is a destroyer, it's got a strength of 80. Interesting. It looks like these cruisers are really, really strong.
Construction complete.
So at least we cleared away those pirates from here. Ah, there's no leader assigned, that's the problem. Now, I do have enough capacity for an extra leader here. Short of enough facilities for this one here, which is a bit of a pity.
Construction complete. Construction complete. Ships upgraded.
Sweet. So if I now look at this here and actually merge these two into one, I should see that this one here will be merging with the main one there.
Construction complete. Construction complete.
Okay, we could do the work on a research station here at the tank. Do I want to send my people and my... Ooh, look at that. That is a useful one to have. Is that one in my realm? No, it's not. Where is that one? Cool.
Construction complete.
Second fleet is complete in terms of what it can do now. Good. Fleet power stands at a good level, I would say. They are still deadly, as you can see. We've recruited our colony ship here. Now, I do want to start colonizing a good planet here. Now this one's 24 in size, that's 13 in size. I think this one of course would then be ideal. So we're entering orbit of that system there. It's size 12. And we do have capacity for one extra one.
Ships upgraded.
Cool. Now I'm not quite sure I want to keep the ship. I've got already a fair number of them. Same goes for this one here. Just need to find some of those ships back in my terrain. Once I do have them back in my terrain, I can actually do something with them.
Research complete.
Research completed. Colony in speed has increased. We can actually go for either the ion disruptors here, or the tachyon sensors, or the X-ray lasers. Let's go for the X-ray lasers. Alright, energy, streaming gas. Okay. These guys down here cannot enter into any pact or anything of that sort with them at the moment. Any other particular agreements I could enter into potentially? I don't see anything of that sort. Since I'm getting to be more and more powerful in my own region, I was kind of hoping to be able to offer these guys here an option. Can I form anything here? Nope. Defensive pact, they don't want to go into a federation with us either. Let's have a look at the factions that we have. As a gift to celebrate the friendship between our two civilizations, a caravan from the subterranean aliens on Jara Primus brought a large quantity of gemstones to the surface. Stones such as these are apparently mined by the Empire deep underground and close to the moon as they day their venture. Wow, good. So it does pay off having friends in places like that. It does, certainly does. Definitely seem to pair. Right, anything else I can actually upgrade on here? Doesn't look like it, does it? So what I'm kind of inclined to go for here is the temple. I could alternatively go for the visitor center, because of course that will not only increase the migration attraction, it will also increase habitability. But I think temple will actually give me spiritualist attraction, okay? Right. Cool. So our scientist is back here. Afterwards he will complete a survey here.
Debris analyzed.
Cool. Active countermeasures is of course a good one to have. Independence being guaranteed. Democratic Thermolium Domain. Okay. Good.
System survey complete.
We just surveyed another system here. More more surveying has to be done in this region here, it looks like. There's here a dimensional anchor, and we actually haven't been able to do anything with this yet. Fleet composition is a dimensional horror, which is level 1. So what have we got in this region here, if I were to look at it? Now that's got a little red star next to it. Intriguing that we can actually see it moving around. Ether Drake, or Ether Drake, whatever you want to call it. Ah! We can increase our energy grid and energy nexus. Now also produce 2 unity. That is nice to have. Cool, look at that. Straight away a boost in terms of unity output.
Construction complete.
Almost ready here to basically build that extra colony. Still cost 30, wouldn't it? Okay. Let's kick up the game speed a little bit and then let us start the production of this colony here. Okay. That should suffice for the moment being. And this should allow us to basically place that quite nicely.
Colonization in progress.
Cool.
System survey complete.
That's one of my
research
governors.
Complete.
Yep. Completed a bit of research, atmospheric manipulation. Habitability. Hostile environment adaptability. Adaption. Okay, now this one, dangerous wildlife. I actually want to remove those blockers, so that is going to be useful.
System survey complete.
A relatively quick one. Let's scan these individual bits here still. Quite a bit of space left in terms of being able to build more destroyers. I'm actually going to build 4 more. Can have a quick look at the surfaces here, see if there's anything else I can upgrade. Otherwise it would look like we're actually going to build up a nice reserve here.
Debris analyzed.
Looks like we can actually upgrade this to a biolab. Ah, active countermeasures. Still on the list of items to
be
researched. Physics and engineering research have been done here. Good. So we do have some science ships again at our disposal here. So where do I want to send these guys to? What have we got here? There's a pirate fleet here. Is there any other systems here that I actually haven't surveyed as of yet? Access to these, so I can't get into there. Looks like I've done most of these already. And this one has not been done yet, so let's try that one out. Okay.
Incoming transmission.
Human people should not be prisoners. Well, let's pause the game. Should not be prisoners in a physical foundation, and neither should our own people be limited to inhabit our own territory. Let us all agree to remedy this by having a. What is it? I guess a migration treaty? I'm quite happy to go with that one. Following a long period of growing support for the Imperial Unity Movement, the Oscorp Plastinanite has finally embraced the faction, adapted their care. The Tarian, okay. Okay. So be it. More migration treaties have come into effect here, it looks like. What can I actually do? Can I invite them to a federation?
System survey complete.
Alright, these guys here again are at my disposal. I would love for them to be able to do something other than basically just mess around here. Alright, this ship here. Maybe this ship here. I'll basically decommission this ship here. And can I straight away assign this person here to actually take over the research, which will actually give me a nice boost on the research there. But of course still leaves me with enough ships here to be able to do other things with as well. Alright, we dealt with that quite nicely, I think. 76, 83, and this person is 63. So relatively young as such. Now, looking at the clock, I think it's about time for us to call the day. Alright, these guys here have actually made an agreement. And it looks like these guys here had to cede some of their planets over to their neighbors. Looks like we completed a bit of research, which is great. Cruiser assembly yards. I'll basically put that on my research list now. Basically what it allows me to do, it allows me to upgrade my space stations here to the next level. Anyways, let's call it a day. So we're going to basically save away the game. Actually, it's auto-saved in Iron Man mode. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to put an end to today's recording. Thanks again for joining me, and I do look forward to seeing you on the next episode. In the meantime, have a great day. Bye-bye.